So today we will be going to do objectives of business. What do we mean by objectives of business? Means what does a business want to do? What is the main aim of the business? So the first aim, first objective of a business is economic objectives. There are four types of objectives. First one is economic objectives. Economic is related to money. Business is an economic activity, as we know, and therefore its purpose is to show economic results. The economic benefits of the objectives of business are as follows. First one is earning profit. What does we mean by profit? When there is an excess of income over expenditure, it is known as profit. When your expenses are less and your income is more, it is known as profit. The first objective of any business or any businessman is to earn profit. No business can survive without earning profit. If your business is incurring losses, then your business won't be surviving for any more. Not only for survival, but it is also required for growth and expansion of business. You need the profit for your growth of the business also, and for the survival of the business. So main objective, economic objective, is to earn profit, and profit is earned for two things. First one is to survive the business, and the second one is for the growth and expansion of business. Now the second one is market standing or creation of a customer. Business can survive for a longer period only if it is able to capture a big share in the market and has market standing. What does we mean by this? A business can survive for a longer period means it can go for a long time. Why? Because it has a big share in the market. He has a goodwill in the market, and from that goodwill only he is able to survive for such a long period. It is possible only when business provides goods and services to satisfy the needs and wants of the customers. How can you create your goodwill or reputation? You can create it only, it can be only possible when you will provide goods and services which will be able to satisfy the needs and wants of the customers. Therefore, creation and satisfaction of customers or market is an important objective of business. The second objective of business is, economic objective of business is for market standing or for the creation of a customer. Third one is innovations. Innovation means making new products or bringing changes in the existing products with whatever you are selling it right now. So innovation means making new products or adding new features of old products for making it more useful, improving methods of production and distribution, exploring new markets, etc. In these days of competition, a business can be successful only when it creates new designs, better machines, improved techniques and new varieties, etc. If you have to survive and you have to beat the competitor, you have to have the new designs, better machines, you should have improved techniques, you should create more and more useful products than your competitors and should give it to the customers at a reasonable price. Then only you will be able to survive in the market for the long period. So innovation is very necessary for survival of the long period in the market. Fourth one is optimum utilization of resources. We have four resources. What are the four resources? Men, material, labor, and machines. These four resources should be utilized in such a way that it should give you the maximum output and you should get more profit out of that. So you have to use your resources without wasting it and in the best possible manner. Fifth one is improved productivity. It is used as a measure of efficiency. Every business enterprise must aim at greater productivity to ensure continuous survival and growth. Now, what do we mean by efficiency? Efficiency means to make more and more products with the available resources and without wasting the resources. And the every business wants that there should be more and more production. Why the business wants more and more production? Because greater the production, lesser will be the cost of production. And whenever you will be having greater production, the more you will survive in the market and more you will grow. This objective can be achieved by reducing wastages. I have told you before only that production can only be achieved, more production, when you will reduce wastage and making efficient use of machines and equipment, human resources, money and etc. Now, these five are the economic objectives. Now we come to social objectives. Okay, social objective is related to society. What is the responsibility of the business towards the society? As you know that we get all the things from the society itself. You get the machines from society. You get the labor from the society because the labor's live in that society only. You get material from that society only. So, society is very useful and very important for the business. So, the business has very more responsibilities towards the society. What are those? First, read it. Business is an integral part of society. It is a part of society. It makes use of resources of society. You make the resources which are there in the society, business is using that only. It earns profit by selling its products or services to members of society. Where does the customers live? Customers also live in that society only and we sell the goods to those customers only and from that only we get profits. So it becomes obligatory on the part of the businessman to do something for the society. Now it's on the part of the business that now he has the responsibility towards society also. Now the most important social objectives of business are as follows. First one is quality goods and services at fair prices. You should give, the business should give the quality products to the society or to the customers at a very reasonable price and in proper quantity on the continuous basis. Example, it is given, consumers look for ISI mark on electrical goods, for FPO marks on food products, hallmark on jewelry. So you should, the business should take care of this also, that the product should be of ICI mark or of FPO mark or any other mark. Second one is avoidance of antisocial and unfair trade practices. Antisocial practices include hoarding, black marketing and adulteration. The business should avoid all this. The business should not do any antisocial practices. Like you should not do any black marketing. Black marketing means, suppose you have got the stock of rice before the increase in the price of the rice. Now you have bought it for less price, and now when there is a shortage of rice in the market, you will sell that rice at the more price. So this is known as black marketing. So business should avoid all this. Making false claims in advertisements to mislead and exploit people is an example of unfair trade practices. You should not give any false advertisement. Means you should not give any wrong information about the product because it can harm the customers also. So this is an example of unfair trade practices which the business should not involve in that. Third one is employment generation. From where does the labor come? Labor comes from the society itself. The businesses should give opportunities to the people living in the society for the employment. You should employ the people from the society itself. Handicapped and disabled people should be given extra care. Fourth one is employee welfare. What does we mean by employee welfare? Employee welfare means the people who are working in their business should get some facilities from us. So this is known as employee welfare. Just read it. Employees are valuable asset and they make significant contributions towards the success of business. We know without employees, a business cannot do anything. They need employees for the successful running of the organization. So, employees are the valuable assets for the business and the business should take care of their assets. So, they should give the proper welfare to their employees. The success of business. Another social objective of business, therefore, is to ensure welfare of employees by providing good working conditions. How can we ensure welfare of employees? We can give them good working conditions where they work. We should give them fair wages and facilities such as housing, medical and entertainment, etc. Such welfare facilities help to improve physical and mental health of employees. Now, the last one is community service. Business should contribute something to the society where it is established and operated. Business, where the business exists. The business exists in the very society. So, library, dispensary, education institutions, etc. Certain contributions which a business can make can help in the development of the community. Now, last one is the role of profit in business. We have learned that the main aim or objective of business is to earn profits. So why do we think that profit is more important for business? So we are doing this in this. Why the profit is important for the business? The following facts are there. First one is for long survival. The basic objective of any organization is to ensure that it continues to survive and exist in the future. Why does we need profit? We need profit for the long survival in the future. Survival in the long run is possible only when organization is able to earn adequate profits. If the business will not earn profits, how will the business survive? For the mere survival of the business, profit is very necessary. Second is expansion and growth. Every businessman wants to expand the business. So how do we expand the business? We need money for that. And from where that money comes? That money comes from the mere profits we earn in the business. So profits is the most important source of finance for the expansion and growth of business. Then measure of efficiency. The efficiency and prosperity of a business is measured through the profit it earns. Higher profits indicate the efficient working of the business. How can you say that a business is doing good or it is earning, he has having good reputation in the business or how efficient the business is doing work? It can only be measured through profit only. The more the profits, the more the goodwill of the business and more the efficiency of the business. Fourth one is reward of risk bearing. We know that every business has inherent in the business risk. Risk is the basic factor of any business. No business can avoid the risk. We have lot of risk involved in this. So the more the risk we take, the more the profit we earn. So an entrepreneur assumes a lot of risk while carrying out business activities. Profit is considered as a reward for bearing this risk. Whenever we bear the risk, the result we get is the profit. If there is no profit in business activity, no one would like to assume risk of running business. Last one is better reputation and goodwill. A profit-making company enjoys better goodwill in the market. The business or the organization who is earning more profit has the more goodwill in the market as compared to loss-making company. A company with better goodwill is able to attract and retain talented workforce. It becomes easy for such a firm to raise loans and obtain credit. The business who is having more goodwill or reputation will get more loans. It can easily raise loans and can get many credit facilities because banks also have a trust on that business that they will repay the money very well.